So first thing first, I'm Radmila Segal, as Nikolai mentioned, and I will talk on Prometheus platform today and on National Technical University of Ukraine, Kyiv Polytechnical Institute, and our MOOC experience and how we are working with MOOC, how we are creating MOOCs today here in Ukraine, and how we are working internationally in our part of discussion. So first of all, let me talk a bit about Prometheus, the biggest platform of MOOCs in Ukraine, and how it was the first one and how we are working nowadays. So I think I will try to talk about it in a storytelling way. So I will tell you a small story on creation of Prometheus. So once upon a time, there was two guys who have a same dream. They've shared this dream. They wanted to bring online courses in Ukraine. They were very much... had a lot of enthusiasm, and they were very familiar with Coursera, edX, Udacity, who started their way at early 2012. And it was 2014, one of the hardest years in Ukrainians' history. It was after the revolution, it was at the beginning of war. And these guys, they've said to me at that time that they needed something that will bring Ukrainians together and that will give them a way to take courses of the greatest university teachers, regardless of age, regardless of sex, regardless of their social status, regardless of their income. So they've needed a platform where Ukrainians can get knowledge at every time and without any, obstacles, I think. Let's call it obstacles. So they've met at scientific conference. It was a PhD students of our the biggest university, National University, Kyiv National University, Ivan Primachenko, and my colleague and friend, Oleksiy Molchanovsky, who taught at Kyiv Polytechnic Institute at that time. And now he is a vice dean of computer science faculty at Ukrainian Catholic University. And they've talked a lot about this idea of creating MOOCs platform in Ukraine. At the time, we have no MOOCs, no online courses, maybe a bit of webinars, but not a lot. And they've talked to a lot of people at that time in Ukraine, a lot of teachers, a lot of international offices, and everybody was like, I don't know, it's not a time for it in Ukraine. I don't know, maybe next year. I don't know, let's see how it will all go in the next couple of years. So, but they have a dream and they needed to bring the dream to life. So, Oleksiy, who was a Fulbright fellow, he was at Fulbright exchange program at Georgia University, and he had an experience with American online courses. So he decided that they need to go with it and they need to create it without any money and without any connections. So they've choose LMS and which Prometheus right now is running. It's OpenEdX. It's the same LMS learning management system that edX has. And for your information, it's I don't know if you're familiar with it, but it's very hard. It's very hard to manage OpenEdX when you are not installing your courses on edX directly, but when you have this platform in your disposal and on your servers. And in Ukraine, we have 2.5 professionals who are working with this platform. One of them is our STO, CTO. He is working with this platform since 2016, and he is top rated specialist in Europe and this platform. And the other 1.5 is one company that trying to manage this in Ukraine, and one student of our university who is only trying to understand how everything works. Because at the back end, they've got a lot of problems and a lot of loose codes and else, because it's open source project, and everybody's trying to change something, to bring new models, new ways to teach there, and it's hard. So guys decided they need OpenEdX because they were in love with edX.org. And they've liked how everything is smoothly going, how videos you can scale and you can change speed and you can add presentation and you have gamification techniques. So they go with it. Oleksiy came to me and said, do you want to create a course for our new platform? Because he has he had some questions to me regarding marketing, because it's my specialty, and I've gave some advices to them at the beginning about marketing, social medias, how they can bring more users when they launch. And he asked me, do you want to create some online course for us? I've looked at him and said, are you crazy? I don't have any time. Which online courses do you want me to create? And he said, you have a great course, and I'm teaching, it's unique for Ukraine. It's not unique in the world, but it's unique for Ukraine. I'm teaching course on editing of translation of for audio-visual products. It's dubbing, it's subtitling, and everything else. And it's very practical. And they wanted me to do it for Prometheus at that time. But I wasn't able at the time. I have no time. So they went to other people and they've got six teachers who created courses for free. It was courses in economics, in history, in logic, and in IT. And these courses, it was Prometheus start. In 2014, in October 2014, Prometheus had three users. Two of them were Ivan and Oleksiy, and the third one was one of the teachers who needed to understand how everything works. A year later, in October 2015, Prometheus has 100,000 users. And everybody in Ukraine who said that it's impossible were very interested how guys managed it. Nowadays, I will finish my history lesson here. Nowadays, we have 1.5 million unique users at Prometheus from 24 countries. Ukraine, the most users from Ukraine, of course, but we have users from United States, from Canada, from all countries of Europe, from Belarus, from Russia, from Moldova, from Baltic countries, from Germany as well. And but the most of them are Ukrainians, of course. We have over 200 courses, because 10 of 12 of them are now in production. And we have managed to bring 800,000 certificates for our courses. Of course, not everyone is finishing our courses. Everybody has a lot of problems. I have friends and a lot of who working with a lot of MOOC platforms, and everybody has the same problem. How we can increase our rate of courses that came to an end with our users? So right now we have these amazing figures, I think, and everybody in Ukraine are talking about this huge success. It was a startup, small startup, but right now we are the biggest online platform in Ukraine. And of course, when other people saw how we managed to bring users, they started to create MOOC platforms as well. Now in Ukraine, we have I think around 10 MOOC platforms, different MOOC platforms. It's very popular in Ukraine right now. And I know that our colleagues from former Republic of Soviet Union, such as Kazakhstan, Uzbekistan, and others, Georgia, they are trying to bring our specialists to create MOOCs for them, because they have no experience, and we have this experience, and we have this huge success. Of course, at the beginning, we have no clue how to do it. It was like, I don't know, I've seen this great course on Coursera, it has video lectures, I think we need to do video lectures. Or, I think we need to do some webinars and tests. Or, I think we need to share our opinions online on webinar, and then we will certificate everybody who attended. It was very rough at the time. I came to the team at late 2016. Guys brought me as an editor-in-chief because there was a lot of courses who and they needed somebody to check it, to correct it and to structure it. And with them, I've started this process of creation of MOOCs and became a MOOCs architect, as we call it, and created around 30 courses, MOOCs with them, and translated a lot of them. And through the years, the last 5 years, we have created our own process, and we have this, I'll call it guidelines. For this presentation, we have guidelines for our teachers, for our lecturers, how to create MOOCs. How to create. We have two online courses on how to create MOOCs. But also we have a guidelines for them to read before they are trying to make something. And this is a five-part process for us. Analysis, design, content creation, installation, and testing. It's a one part, and evaluation. And I will talk a bit about every part of this process for you to understand how is working Ukrainian MOOCs platform. So, of course, the first one is analysis. The first thing we are trying to understand with our teachers is target audience. Because when you don't know which people need to see this course, need to get knowledge from your course, you don't know how to make it. Because when you are trying to make a course for students at university, it's one point of view. When you are trying to make course for people who are living in small towns and the villages in Ukraine is a second way to prepare it. When you need to create something for people who have no experience in the field is a third way. So we are trying to bring our teachers to this understanding. What are those people? Who are them? Where do you need to find them? How you can reach them? And I'm trying to make them to prepare these small portraits on each person to whom they need to share their knowledge. It's very, it's great and they like it because it's not just my audience is people from Kyiv, they are 20 or 30 years old. They have, I don't know, for example, Maxim, 27 years old, works as IT specialist, and he likes to learn something new in his field or other fields. And they are trying to understand their audience in this way. After that, we have a small interviews with potential target audience to understand how they want to have this information, how they need to have this information. And after that, only after that, we are trying to understand what similar courses we have, not only in Ukraine, but in the world. Because it's very important how this topic was understood in other countries and what do we need to learn from them and what do we need to bring to our listeners, to our students here in Ukraine. After that, we are trying to start design process. We have, I think I need to tell you that we how much people are working on MOOCs in Prometheus. We have a project manager. We have a methodologist, the person who works with lecturer. We have designer, of course, a person who is responsible for all the visual parts in our process. We have a production team. It's people who are preparing our video, making editing with this video, subtitling this video if needed. And we have technical team. Technical team supports course and they provide technical support and they are installing it on our platform. And of course, we have as well our marketing team. But marketing is one of the biggest topics in MOOCs right now. And I think if you have a question, I will talk a bit more about it. But I think it's a, another lecture, but we have a marketing and they are working with us as well. So on a design stage, we are trying to understand which title do we need to give to our course, because title is very important for marketing and title is very important to understand what do you need to share with your audience. The aim of the course, what, why we are doing it, what do we need to bring. The main problems to solve, we are trying to make as a list of problems which we need to solve with our course. And we are trying to make it with a Bloom taxonomy, but if you have another way to create this part, you can take anything, but you need to create main problems to solve, or is one of the main parts of each online courses creation. And of course, after that, we have a very, a lot of things we need to structure. So we have a structure in, and every hour course have a Google spreadsheet or a board. We are trying to use Notion, Trello, Asana, Jira, or anything that is, I don't know, very, not very complicated for our authors, because one of right now we have an author who hasn't any experience with boards, so we've created a Google spreadsheet for him. It's the best way for him. Some of our lecturers they create mind maps. I think it's a way to bring this structure, because when you have structure, you understand how much topics you need to cover. How many lecturers will you have in each topic? How many video lecturers? What additional materials you need to bring? How many tests? And how these tests will, or exercises will look like? Because a lot of different ways to evaluate students' knowledge we have in our platform. And do you need a creative task, or do you need on tests only? What is the final exam or final project for your course and everything else, and how much time will it take? Because in my experience, the greatest MOOC is 4 weeks long. 4 weeks, and it's you can cover any topic in 4 weeks. Of course, if it's not a master degree program, then you need to cover fundamental parts of any topic or fundamental parts of some sphere, I think. So when you have a structure, you can go to the content creation. Before, it's no good to create any content, because you can trash it, you can go all over again. So the first type of the content that we are trying to create with our team and with our lecturers is scripts for video lecturers. I have some lecturers who are telling that they don't need any scripts. They will go to the studio and they will bring it. And after that, they are going to the studio and they are not bringing it. And I think it's the best way to create scripts is to write them. Is to write them very detailed. In each part, you need to understand what visual content will you use here. Is it infographics, or maybe it's presentation, or maybe you need to do animation here, or maybe you need some, I don't know, bullets on a screen, or with marked lists on the screen, or something else. So you need to write it down. It's the best way to understand how much time you need for this lecture and what is your visual content for this lecture. After that, we are creating tests and exercises. The main problem here is when our authors trying to create tests which are not covering all the materials they have in lectures. Something they are bringing from additional materials or from some other, I don't know, some other articles they've read online or they've wrote even, but it wasn't in the course. And people, they don't understand what to do, how they can make this possible. And they need to cover this test because they need to get certificates, of course. After that, we are preparing additional materials because it's very important to make some, I don't know, some points where to go after this course. Where do you need to go when you finish our course? Where do you need to go to watch something else? Or where do you need to go to read more about the topic? So we are adding additional materials. After that, we are thinking, do we need or not creative tasks? Creative tasks are great in our experience, the way to show how people understand what they learn in our course, how they need to work on something more, or what do we need to do to update this course, because it's very, very important, very interesting. And of course, we are thinking, do we need gamification here or we don't? We have experience in creating games for our courses. It's a small video games we have for one of our courses, and small games like puzzle games for our courses and for public servants. And they've loved it because their work is very routine. They have a lot of paperwork. And in our course, they have, for a change, they have to play a puzzle game. And we have a great response. And I think it's one of the way to increase our success, to increase our rate of certificates at the end of each course. Installation and testing is the next part, is a technical part. Of course, our technical team preparing materials for installation because OpenEdX has its limits, of course. And we need to understand what we can and what we cannot install at our platform. After that, they are installing all the content, and all of our team who works on this course, everybody is testing this content. And testing and testing and testing. After that, we bring beta users. We have the beta testers, we call them, and they test these materials as well. And after that, our marketing team tests this material and they are starting marketing program. After everything is put on the platform, in early stages, they can create some posts on Facebook that we are working on this course or on that course, but their main work begins after installation. And of course, evaluation. I think it's a key element in MOOCs creation, because when you understand results, you can understand what you need to do next. Of course, we have two main metrics we are using, is how much users enroll in this course, and which number we have at the end. How many of them reach certificates, and so what do we need to do to up this figure, to level up from that. Certificates is the second point. We have courses where people are posting on web that they don't understand how to get certificate. They tried everything. They've made every task. They've tried to create a creative task, and they've bring everything they've got, and they haven't got a certificate. What to do? And it's a huge problem. And I think when we have this, we need to update this course completely, rethink this course completely. And it's an important way for us is to get the feedback. We have a Facebook, we have a Twitter, we have a Telegram channel. And of course we have our forum at platform where our users share their opinions on our courses and propose what we need to change. And these improvements and changes are the next step in our courses creation. We are beginning from the start and we are trying to bring something new in this course. And we have, I think, all of our past courses from 2015 and 2016 are remade right now. We resort them and we make a lot of changes. We are making a lot of changes right now for them, for these courses. And I think we will rethink them in the future one more time, of course. Prometheus is not only MOOCs creation and MOOCs installation platform. We are creating a lot of courses and we are providing our technical support for courses created by our colleagues or partners. So, for example, Lviv School of Business have created a lot of courses and they brought it to our platform, but it was their content, it was their course, we only provide technical support for them. But also we have piloted two blended learning, projects, let's call it, in Ukraine. And all over Ukraine. In the first pilot was in 2016 when Prometheus translated one of the greatest courses in programming in the world, top rated course of Harvard University, CS50, Introduction to Computer Science by Professor David Mullen. And this course was our first step to blended learning implementation in the biggest universities in Ukraine. We have four partners. In 2016, it was my university, Igor Sikorsky, Kyiv Polytechnic University. It was Lviv National University. It was Lviv Polytechnical University, Lvivska Polytechnika, and it was Kyiv National University, National University of Kyiv. And these four universities, and of course, after that, Ukrainian Catholic University was included. They've needed this course as well. And they've get this course from us in Ukrainian translation, and they've put it in their educational program as a part of a computer science course, or as a part of technology course, they have a technology course, or as a part of their web programming course, or as a part of their Python language course. And everything went really great. Students were very excited. They have certificates, they have their marks for this, they have a lot of experience, and even they have a final project evaluated by the top IT companies in the country. After that, blended learning we have a lot of our courses in blended learning format with different universities, but the second pilot was also CS50, the newest version of the course. We translated in 2019. It was professional translation. It was professional voiceover, and if you want, I will show a small piece of it. And this translation was a huge success for us, and we launched a pilot with 20 universities with this course in blended learning. And of course, the main university who uses is my university, because I'm responsible for blended learning in National Technical University of Ukraine, Igor Sikorsky, Kyiv Polytechnic Institute. And we are not only using this course, CS50, on our six faculties right now, but we also use different courses on digital communication, on digital marketing, on deep learning, that we have on Prometheus, on economics, on startups. We are using them at a lot of parts of our university, and I think it's a huge success for us, and it's our way to bring the best knowledge from top universities in Ukraine to small universities, and it's our way to bring world-class courses to Ukrainian universities and to Ukrainian users. You don't need to go to Harvard to learn from David Mullen right now. And he promised he will come to Ukraine, but pandemic hits and he haven't, but he was very excited because they were working on Spanish translation for at least 3 years now. And Ukrainian translation, we have two. Ukrainian translation for his course right now. And he was very excited, and I think he will come to Kyiv someday. But right now we are teaching his course as he teaches it in Harvard and Yale simultaneously, because they have this program, exchange program in blended learning format as well. And as for Igor Sikorsky, Kyiv Polytechnic Institute, we have a lot of experience in blended learning and MOOC creation. Right now, before the pandemic, we have not a lot of online courses. We have tried some with Prometheus, and we have tried some on Moodle We have a Moodle platform in our university, but in March of 2020, everything changed. And we needed to understand how to teach in a new world. Thus, we have created our platform for distant learning. It's called Sikorsky Distant. It has, I think it has a lot of potential. It's in early stages. We have Moodle there and we have Google Classroom there. Two ways to teach. And our teachers, our professors, they've decided for themselves what part of this technical support they need. Or it's Moodle or it's maybe Google Classroom. And we have almost 4,000 courses right now at Sikorsky Distance because we needed to teach these courses to our students because Igor Sikorsky Kyiv Polytechnic Institute gone distant and we haven't any blended format with our students in classes. We have our classes in Google Meet or in Zoom. All the year, this academic year was the same. It was only distant learning. And for that, we needed to create something that will give our teachers instruments to teach. And Sikorsky Distance is one of these instruments. Of course, we are using Prometheus courses and other platforms, but Sikorsky Distance is our own. And right now, we have a production team in university to shoot videos. We have a technical support team to provide our teachers with instruments at Sikorsky Distance. And of course, we have a team who trying to market this all of this, but I think they need to maybe to bring more to this part because we are not very, I don't know, not a lot of posts about it because maybe we need to share more. Maybe our teachers need to share more, but in future, I think we will get to this. So in Igor Sikorsky Kyiv Polytechnic Institute, we have this project on blended learning with Prometheus, and we have our platform, Sikorsky Distance. And for future, I think I need to talk a bit about future of our university and the future for Prometheus. As for our university, I think the next step is to create all our courses in online format, everything. Because we have experience in this and because such universities as MIT, Harvard, as Oxford, they have all the courses in online format and the student can choose what and how they need to get this knowledge. And I think it's our future, it's future for our university. And as for Prometheus, in early 2020, we launched paid content, paid courses, not free only, because before 2020, all of our courses were free of charge. And right now we have a paid content. It's not a lot. It's about 12 or 15 courses right now. It's courses in business and IT. And we are creating these courses today with our colleagues from the biggest IT companies and entrepreneurs and pharmaceutical internships and other things. But these courses gave us an opportunity to pay for our free courses. For creation of our free courses, because we have grants, of course, we have sponsorships, we have our donations from our students, but it's not a lot. And to create a great content, we need to have money for it. And it was the main purpose to create paid content. I think we have a huge success with paid content and we will bring more, but our priority is free content. Of course. And the biggest part of Prometheus, it's free content and it will stay this way because our mission is to bring the greatest, the biggest, the most important MOOCs for Ukrainians free of charge, regardless of age, of tax, of health issues and social status as well. I think this is everything I've needed to tell you this day. Here is my contact. You can reach me at any part of this of the web, email, Facebook, Twitter, Telegram, or you can go to our sites, it's Prometheus sites and KPI. And I think I've I need to show you our platform for a bit. I've have you can see our landing page. Here you can find everything. You can find our courses, our partners. You can find how to reach our courses, what you need to do, feedbacks from our listeners, our blog. And here is how our platform looks like inside. It's typical edX, open edX, but with our elements. It's our CS50 course, the second translation. It's CS50 2019, Introduction to Computer Science. So thank you very much. If you have any questions, I'm ready to answer.